perform inside, and from here wonderfully all the basic techniques could come up. You see, the moment he blocks from the inside, bam, I come in, I attack you, we have Temakura, Omotek, Yaku, all different joint locks come from this boxing scenario. Kick him up, boom, kick him, punch him, bam, boom, throw him, anything you like. The idea is you hit two times with the same hand.
The small step means, doesn't matter how fast this guy is, he's never faster than his first step.
And I boom, and I practice, you see, moving the arm, the second arm is still up, boom, all the way inside, my hip is pushing the elbow, boom, throwing back, so I create again some distance. Did I have, bam, you hit me? Boom, boom, boom. There can be, boom, one small inch punch, and the second hit to the face, and you come to Ogyaku. Let's say you, boom, you stand on one leg, and excuse me, boom, okay. And the same on the other leg, but it's a circular motion, it's like blocking and then turning into, you see, whoom. Okay, the arms are here, and I can feel I could be lifting, like Bagua, lifting his arm, turning his arm, whoom, and then pushing him, okay? Get out of the torque. This is the original kata. So let's look into the finer points of the kata. In the way, what we do, we fractalize the kata. We put all different separate parts and look at them from a certain perspective. And the very first, actually, is Jumonji kata in itself. It's Jumonji no Kamae in itself. Look, Jumonji, Ju means 10 in Japanese. It's like X in Latin. Understand? So this is a way for you to remember me. And every time you look at the photo, you see the teacher like this. There is an aspect, maybe, you know, some Qigong, what I like very much, that you have a reason why to put like this, and women maybe the other hand, all different ideas. But basically, look, Jumonji no Kata, let's say we are not in a Kion, he's not friendly with me. I took his parking spot like I did a few times today, and I stand like this, and he will hit me. I have to react, you understand? I don't know how he's punching me. So the Jumonji no Kamae, if I'm here, it's good for the photo, you know? After you see, this was Yakov here, or this was Yossi Sensei, or Moshe Kasei, anybody, you know? It's Atsumi, it's nice for the picture. But if I want to defend myself, the arm should be more up, defending my body, you know? If I go low, doesn't matter if I stand high. So imagine yourself, your head in the window. So the window can be like Hoko no Kamae, can be like Kosei no Kamae, can be Jumonji. Somehow your head gotta be protected, otherwise he will hit you. Okay, so this is the very first thing we should do when we think about Jumonji, is that the arms are supposed to be strong. So let's say he's in Jumonji now, defending his arms a bit. Try not to put the arms always together. Because let's say I'm very aggressive to him, and you will get up in Jumonji and say, what are you doing? It's not so smart, you see? The arms, I recommend put one fist in between, and the pressure, like Jumonji, the pressure should be, if I resist, doesn't matter which hand I press from here, it should be on me. See, put on the other hand, the second one, it doesn't matter, come from the outside, okay, it doesn't matter from which side the pressure is, there should be always a way of resisting it, you know. It's the first form of Kamae. Let's say you're really scared, and I'm completely surprised, I'm injured, tired, drunk, and anything. He comes to me, punch anyway, just cover myself. You see, the first punch goes even 2-3 without crucially hitting you in the chin or in the neck or in the eye or in the nose that will make you cry or bleed or anything, you understand? It's the first way to cover yourself up. You remember these old movies, Duck and Cover, from the American against the atomic power, you see? So, I come to you, and all you do is you cash into me and cover up, Jumonji, won't see. Once again, boom, see, it doesn't matter, you know, see, I trick him, but he's still safe because he runs, he dashes into me, he's kind of safe. So the very first idea, just try to practice that, and from there we will go on with the blocking and punching.
Okay.
If I just go straight in, like we do, like let me show you, we have basic lessons, we designed the ninjutsu basic program into 30 basic lessons that we want a student to be able to perform. They always consist of one stand-up subject, punching, kicking, joint manipulation, throwing, and one ground fighting, or one knife, one weapon subject, and one taijutsu. Would you like to help me for a second? One of them, for example, is the use of urasone and kamae against a person who would punch on the street or attack on the street, plus the connection from there to Osota Serenage. Like, actually, if you think about Osota Serenage, it's a very complicated throw, you know, yakuzeo, all these different variations. If you think about it from a judo, jiu-jitsu sparring position, you know, maybe, but in the street fight, it's not against somebody who resists, not so light. So, what I will do, from very much the same idea, like a kamae, you all know gashon rei, when you start to bow, of course, also there's from the, not from the heart meridian, Pericard meridian, there's a certain idea how to keep the arm strong, to close the energy circle. But let's stay fighting for a second. I'm here, he punches me with, I don't know, left side, right side, boom, okay? Here, see, it's the punch is a block. I'm not blocking him. If he hit the other side, boom, the arm is also up blocking. You see, I'm not hitting Urasto in such a way. I'm throwing it more from a vertical into a horizontal line by that defending myself. The same as, let's say, the boxer already stands like boxing position and I punch him, he really resists strong. See, this is Urasto, strong guy, but if I punch 45, because these muscles that are, you know, needed for inside-outside rotation, they're always weaker than the other muscles. So why should I be stronger? You know, I should be smarter. And using Urasto in a way, it has more effect. So back to that idea. The only idea, let's say he hits straight. Boom. He hits straight the other side. Boom. Same idea, I'm always covered somehow. But if he comes with an uppercut, there's the loop. So what I do, boom, I go a little bit, not always 45, maybe a smaller angle, a bit outside. Plus, I hit first. Because in all martial arts, what I see many times, the people, they first make the step, and then they hit. But why shouldn't he hit me while I step? Understand? Let's say in the end, you will do it so wrong, that it will be perfect, because you will not punch and then hit. But you will punch and hit the foot on the floor and the punch and the face will connect at the same time. It's a lot of power. But it's better to hit it before my foot steps on the ground than to first step and then hopefully look. It's not like that you will come with a ski and wait a half an hour for you to perform a kata. You know, you will punch, bam, 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 a few times, knee, left, right. You don't know. So by using the angulation and using the kamae, I think the Japanese term is koraino kata, using the kamae as a fighting tool. No? Because you're not going to run after somebody with ichimonji for half an hour in the supermarket just because he took the last beer. This is not how it functions. No, you have to imagine the fight is like a bus ride, and the kamae, they are the junctions, the stops. This is how we see it. So you see, and punch comes on the other side, boom, I'm here, and after this going out, easily, it will come up to the same. If you punch the other side, oh, okay. So the same idea is now, let's not go all the way straight in, you punch anyway, boom, a little bit outside, and for all the advanced ones, you can always look for ways to seize him up, boom, kick him, punch him, boom, throw him, anything you like, what you know so far from your seat. Thank you. It just looks painful,
it's not. Looks? No.
Stepping and what will be with the hands if he really attack me, not just left, right in the kata, if you, like, I don't know, you kick, punch, I don't know what will be in the end. We have three different ways of interpretation for the block and for the punch. So basically, you actually have to go a second. The kata is basically about few things. One of them is to hit few times with the same hand. Could be I hit him, he block, boom, I hit him again. Or I while he punch me, I move out and I punch again. Or let's say walk straight, can be with, you know, many different variations. The idea is you hit few times with the same hand. Nothing special. Boxers do it all the time. Okay? Angulation, stepping, arm emplacement, and as always, what's the hidden meaning of the kata? Why we practice, you can say, okay, I want to practice both sides. So I learn left and right. One, two, three. You know, I remember in the beginning we did a block or chicane, and we really throw something, like you have sand or change in your hand. And then Doron used, many times he used more elegant moves, like just throwing like this could be like sand or metubushi. And then I remember one time Doron showed a version with a block, with a boshi can and shaku can to the face to explain the, I think I remember it was a gyokuryu version of the whole thing. I'm right? The Bushinkan guys, they know. I'm not very bad with katas, but I remember all the name, and I have, luckily I have a photographic memory, so I remember every lesson, almost every lesson from the beginning to the end. So, let's look into the three different ways of blocking. The first one will be his Ichimonji. If you want for comfort, for reason of comfortability, you can start from Shizen now for the understanding part. And you will punch, boom, so you have a block, you see, the arm is really all the way away from me. Let's say he comes with a bit more pressure, more power, boom, you see, the body weight is also shaking, he's losing his balance a bit. And now if I come in with a small step, with a falling step, boom, push he can, really inside. You see, I'm not trying to keep the arm straight, it's a little bit curved, so if the hip is pushing first, I lose power. It's like my hip, you know, this time from the surface, like my hip is transferring, bam, the power of push he can, inside, bam, and then I throw. The very first idea, okay? One more time, even from Kamai. See, his weight is more 60-40 to the back, my weight is more 60-40 to the front. The first thing I check, even if we start with this scenario, he will punch me, I see, can he actually get me? Because many times I'm 50% here, there's no reason for me to move. You know, by the way, why we are still attacked like this? Even though your teacher and I like much more different ideas, you know why we do? Give me an idea, it's not a fish tank, you can talk to me. Why are we still stuck with the sea? Did you? Who of you go sometimes out in the nightlife of Tel Aviv? You're all married. But you remember from the when you were young, you know, when you had the hair not here but there. Obviously, you know, you have to be happy for a second, you know. Did you ever see somebody at home with a ski? Karate, jiu-jitsu, ninja? No, never. But why we still do it? And let me give you one way. Why? What we explain the beginners why we do it. I worked a few years as a bouncer in a nightclub. And I had a lot of interesting experience because of my character in a certain time of my youth. So let's put it this way. The reason why we keep it, it's from the outside, the way people today train it, it looks irrelevant or not realistic. But I see good fighters, boxers, Thai boxers, lose in a street fight, even though they knew their moves and they were quick, because the person would not attack like the guys in the dojo. The guys in the dojo, now you will think something about like standing there for half an hour. No, in the dojo can also be like a kickbox guy. Because he's used to 1, 2, 3 attacks, then I go back, no, I can't want to. It's a rhythm. It's almost like a dancing with, not just with night turns. Why we still do it? I explain it. Because a person in the street, very unlikely, I will come to him if I have trouble and just punch him a bit like this. I will come, let's say I come with the wrong hand, I do a ski in the wrong way, with a lot of physical presence. And people are intimidated and they're hypnotized by the speed of the physical presence. Look, if I let's say we are in a conversation, I said, I don't want one. The way we explain our students, very interesting things. If I'm here, this is, especially in GZM, the chances for me to defend is very unlikely. You can punch left, right, knee, elbow, headbutt, you can spit in my face, put his coffee, millions of things. Plus I will be hypnotized by him. You know, somebody will hit me from the side, all these stupid things. So what I do, you remember the handshake, okay? Good old fashioned handshake among the gentlemen. It's not only because I want him not to grab my sword, this was not the only idea, because if you're here say, you know, I like to see you on top, you're not trouble. You see, I cannot hit him without a small step. The small step means, doesn't matter how fast this guy is, he's never faster than his first step. So let's say he will come to me with one punch or kick, I don't know what, okay? I never saw this person in my life. He will come with any attack, okay, punching, and I don't know what will be, boom. So see, I just move 45, basic principles, and I don't know what will be, because this step gives me time. Too far is not too smart, because all of you who had physics till the, you know, 8th or 9th grade know that after a few steps, the acceleration kicks in and you will be much faster, much more difficult for them. Not at all. So, why we explain our students? Sometimes a beginner, a white belt, can be in a situation that you learn all different moves, but he doesn't have the idea for Mai, for Ritsudo, for Nagare, for flow, rhythm, distance, all these things.
If I keep this distance with him, handshake, nice to meet you, no?
I know he cannot punch me, unless he makes a step. So, from a mental point of view, if he makes one step towards me, just a step, please don't make any trouble. First of all, I will not go backwards. I will go in an angulation, I will use an angle 45. Because there might be somebody, and I try to find a way to see the rest of the room. But even this, we tell students, it's up to you if you do it. Why? Because look, for a physical and for a mental, emotional reason. If I go backwards all the way, I will be with my weight on my heels. Do me a favor, with me together. Stand on your heels for 1 second. Try to hit. You see, there's not much power. Can you really beat? Let's say your opponent is a complete idiot, he knows nothing. He's even not strong. But now stand way forward and hit, and you will see with any power. So from a technical point of view, from the anatomy of the body, it's very stupid to go backwards too much. That now comes to the mental, emotional, side. If a person will go backwards too much, he will get scared and uncertain. And the other person that's uncertain and scared if he wants to approach you for whatever reason, you will be more comfortable because you work there, but then you will feel that the story of the success is painting in the brain. So going backward is not the smartest idea. I don't know how the law kicks in here, but the other way for me to create a distance, not going back, is I do a nice and not nice version. I say, look, I didn't saw. If you want, you can have a, I see he's too aggressive. No, I push him. So now we created more distance, okay? If he comes now and attack me, at least in Germany, the law will say, look, I punch him, he just punched me back, even though I was in the right, I punch first. The lawyer will say, or the judge will say, look, he just defends himself. If he now decides to come again for me, the European law will say, look, he made a consciousness decision to fight you. So now you have all the legal rights to defend yourself, you understand? So you tricked him into something that anyhow would have happened, but now with a different legal consequence for you. Plus, I have distance, and I can follow. The not so nice version will be that you just hit his forehead. He will not die like in the movie if you don't hit the Shikan Ken. If you hit strong, some people, they will just shut up for a moment, which is actually good. And most people, they will just be shocked and very intimidated. Some people will even cry, and they will be mentally shaken. So it's something very good. Why we do all this talking? Look, relax. If I don't create the distance, and I will get nervous, you understand? I don't know, he will stab. What do I do? What was Jumanji? What did Jumanji Kata? What did I learn today? It's a lot of things happening in the same time, physically, mentally, emotionally. So, what I recommend you to use kata, to use kamae, to use all the vada, or to learn all the techniques, give yourself some, I don't know how to explain it in English, give yourself some, like a border, like a invisible fence that he doesn't know. Could be that I say, look, it doesn't matter how aggressive he is and what he cursed from my mother is 80, I don't know what he wants with 80, you understand, you can always find a way to laugh about the curses of people, don't get too emotional, don't get too wild, let people be happy with what they say, because you live with them usually 5 minutes, they live with themselves the rest of their life. So I could say, this is all too aggressive, the moment he will put his hands up, I will start punching him and pushing him away. Or let's say I imagine a line on the floor and he will cross that line. Boom! And I start punching him. It looks for all the people around, it looks like you're acting, but you're not. You're reacting. We know from the Wild West, from the few people who used to ride things in this time, that when there was a gunfight, high noon, most of the time the guy who drew second would win. Why? It's central nervous system, remember what you learned in school. There's one is an active thing. Like I decide I want to shoot him, and the other one, like the hand on the hot stove, you're scared. You understand? You just they don't need him. He doesn't need to know that you're reacting. Because then you will be faster. Plus, you have the idea that the arm moves first. So already two ideas that will make you quicker. Plus the idea you will cover up using the kamae. So few basic ideas, actually white belt ideas, will help you fight much better. So let's get back to the kata. He comes with ski, with a lot of pressure, and I practice, you see, moving the arm, the second arm is still up, boom, all the way inside, my hip is pushing the elbow,
boom, throwing back, so I create again some distance, and from here I could even use maybe the second step and we stay with this for now. Okay? Do it quick because I talk too much and I want you to learn more. The second idea is, first of all, before we come to the second one, people here, so everybody will be here. You all see actually, because actually what we do is in my place we all stand on one side, so it's easier. No, you don't need to. But for at least for the beginner class, because I see it's mixed, some black belts, some white belts. The beginners always stand on one side, so the teacher knows exactly from which angle he can show, even a few times, so everybody will see. Because some people, they immediately know where to stand as close as possible, and some people, they will always stand in a way that they don't catch what was going on. The second hand in this kata, he can't really, it will be here, you see what happens to the body, you know? The second hand will always be here. If I'm here, even though I would be strong to hit him, it will be hard for me to defend the second hand, you see? He will be very quick. It's just as normal, just like a boxer, you know, he will be very quick. So from here, if the second hand is here, it doesn't matter if you punch straight or you punch across, or I don't care. You see, it's a very small decision for me to do this. Plus, while you do whatever you want to do, while you do whatever you perform, the second hand comes in. From here, I don't know, we don't have cushions here. I don't know, can I take you for a second? Because he doesn't care. He's a young kid. He doesn't care about pain so much. All these small hits, like Fudoken, Umotes to Urasto, they can be done in a big way. They can also be done in a bad way. I already feel bad. They can be done in a very, very small way. So, let's look for example into Mushadori. No, you can do boom from here, and before I come into Mushadori, there can be boom, one small inch punch, and the second hit to the face, and you come to Ogyaku, Ganseki, anything. And these small hits, because some people say, you only have power from here, or only power from here. Where comes the power if you're already there, you know? The power comes not because you are strong, strength. The German word for strength, Kraft, you know, Chazak, strong, you know? It comes from the root of the word, is this movement. How we say it? Let's say you have a snake, the snake will turn, it will kringle, you know, will, like a krapfen, like a strudel, like this. This is the root of the word strength. Think about how stupid. You want to be a strudel or a snake? I don't know, maybe somewhere. But the idea of strength actually comes from an unlimited, unbroken chain reaction of small movements. This is how you can gain strength. Sometimes you hear stories or you read stories in the newspaper, small woman, 50 kilo, she lift the car, I have no need just to catch the baby underneath. How is it possible, you know? You can lift the car, I don't. So, let's say you be strong, I do an inch punch. I do it to the belly, so it's not so bad as to the ribs. See, boom, it's the same idea. In the same kind of power, you can create, let's say, boom, you stand on one leg, and excuse me, boom, and the same on the other leg. And it's not really hitting, it's just like throwing the hand first. I remember my teacher was much harder to me, so I suffer with you. So Castillo sees this, you might regret it. Look, when you open a door, you will not open a door like this. The hand will move first. So the same will be, the hand move first, and if you want, you can put some hip power into it. And this will be the same for the face. You don't need distance to create power. Actually, power is really something for idiots. Really for idiots. When people don't know how to hit and they're angry, you know how they hit? Let's say how many, if you go from 0 to 100%, most people say, well, hit them 100%. So let's say you look like a strong guy. I hit him 100% in the head, and I even hit him good here or here. You know how his face will look like? But I also know how my hand will look like, because my hand will look equally as kebab like your face. So with this hand I cannot punch no more, and he has a lot of good strong friends, so they make kebab out of me, you understand? It's stupid. 20, 30, 40% is enough to hit a person to knock him out and to keep your hands, you know, happy for the rest, whatever you want to do. Even Takamatsu sensei used to say that all these toughening exercises for the hand and for the fist is stupid. You go home to your wife, it will feel like a melon, you know, like a avatiak and not like a woman. And you will lose all the sense, it's stupid, really stupid. So you don't have to hit so strong, you have to hit placed right and while moving. Very important, but we hopefully come to this today. So the second idea for hurting you for Jumonji no Kata will be, I showed one slope, is not the first idea that I will try to move the arm away and break the balance and then come all the way in, but it's a circular motion, it's like blocking and then turning into, you see, whoom, whoom, okay? Second hand will always be here in case something happens, boom. So you can practice with a partner a few times, like the blocking and hitting is one motion, one elliptic movement. So he comes with the ski, I stand in the shizem, with the monji, whoom, see, whoom, immediately, whoom, inside. Blocking and hitting, and the second hand is here, and just in case you want to throw a funny punch, other hand, there will always be one hand up and close with it. Yeah, close with it. So your face doesn't look like it. And see, but we speak all the time about let's get more realistic, more into sparring mode. So start already from Jumonji, pressure to the side, pressure up, pressure front, closing, opening, different ideas. Don't put the hand too close together. Make sure your face is hidden. You immediately can turn from one kamae to another. It can be hoku 1 second, closing Jumonji, all different. You know, this we hopefully do in the air. Stay from the kamae and from here, whoosh, come into this movement. Okay, and you just do it a few times, locking and hitting in one movement. If you want, in the beginning you can do it big, and later it's just whoosh, just very short. And in the end. Very interesting question that will again disturb the flow of the lesson, but it's very good. About the leg emplacement. He said he saw, it's very smart that he looks at the leg, that sometimes I have the heel up or the leg is more turned like this and wide like this. So the way I learned from Moshe and from Doron, we have a few different ways of interpretation of, I don't even know exactly from which school, how to perform Jodan Uchiuke. There's a closing hip and there's an opening hip. So with the closing hip, let's say the basic idea is I move backwards and while I close the hip, I pull the leg and in the same moment I lift the arm. So this is one version of it. See, from here you have much more pressure options forward, you know. Doesn't matter how you hit, what you do, if you have a knife, more pressure towards your opponent, even though you go 45 backwards, you can create pressure towards the person you're going away from, so to speak. One idea of koku kata. What it means, koku? Ko is small, and ku is a space. You know, you create a small space that he can put any interpretation of the situation, you see something else in it. So, the other one is the opening hip. You open the hip and you open the arm. You see both movements, okay? Right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you'd like to help me one time? We will not go paint. So, let's say he puts his both arms like this. It's a basic exercise for white belts, what we do. We want to create yellow belts that be able to do, that be able to do sparring with boxers, Thai boxers, kickboxers, with basic ninjutsu principles. And all of you who will see it now, you don't need me after this no more for this shit. You know, you can just copy it and do it yourself. Let's look at it for a second. Let me stand here, because here we have exact 45 degree would be more or less like here, 1 meter to this side, 45 degree to the back, so I have a diagonal line, and I have 90 degree to the side. Six directions I can do with a Tobi, with a kaiten, with a jump, it doesn't matter, with anything, with a punch, with a kick. Let's look at it. Basic is always good to take the second leg, so he cannot step on my foot. Let's forget about it for 1 second, okay? For weapons, for knife, for sparring, later, it's good for a street fight situation or for this exercise, not needed for a second. I move 45 forward. First the step and then the hit. Uh-huh. First the hit and then the step. Boom. Arms up. I move 90 degrees to the side. I move 45 to the back. First the step and then the hit. Uh-huh. This is the latest point where we all understand why first to hit. Okay? Because here we're not hitting. Boom. It's like I push myself away using his nose, 45 outside, okay? So the same, I can have 45 to the inside, 90 degree, 45. So far, so good. This makes sense, no? Let's use the other hand. So I go 45 forward, I go 90 degree to the side, boom, I go 45 back, and the same using the other hand. Always keeping the hands up to defend myself. And now we can be smarter. We can, let's say we do one standing, one going, even one going back. One standing, one going. In the end, you might do something smart, one standing, one going, one putting your foot on the floor, or one standing, one kicking, anything.
And by just by doing sparring, you're very relaxed, you will not always do back and forward because you will all look like in these old fencing movies, okay? And it's a sad thing. Any martial art you look in, doesn't matter how beautiful, Philippine and Thai and anything, they practice all beautiful moves, and in the end they do more or less kickbox sparring. We have ninjutsu, so when you fight, you boom, you use angles, go backwards, go forwards, you go outside, use all the time, use the angulation while you spar. And I recommend you take a mouthpiece, take a head guard, take big gloves, don't mind getting hit in the beginning, and practice the stepping and using the angle while you do sparring. After maximum a month it will take you, and all of your sparring results, they will skyrocket. Because you will not go backward, forward, you go backward, forward, with this guy is maybe not the smartest because he's bigger and stronger than the other, see from the distance, so why should I do this? You know, I'm not 20 anymore and the strongest in the room. This is stupid. Why should I use, we have ninjutsu, so yes, use the principles. So, back to number three. We have a big block opening and a full step inside, making sure the hip push. Number one, we had this circular movement that our hip drags him and our hip pushes or throws the punch in an elliptic movement. Now the third one is what we call a friend of mine from, I learned it from three different teachers, and one friend of mine from a certain martial art, he gave the name skipping stone to it. And we joke on him many times, say, probably it's his Indian name, okay? You know skipping stone? When you are on the lake, you do like this. So it will not function if you do this average, you know, pushy punch and wait here half an hour. You really have to punch me, boom, you see, boom. It's even shorter, it's more like we do a few times just standing. So the stronger he hit, you see, the stronger he hit, boom, boom. If my hand will be pushed off it by his arm, bang, into his face, by me going backward, boom, with forward pressure. I will do a hit to the body, not to the face, boom. Okay, this is the idea. The pressure, boom, off his arm into his face. So we have a defensive stepping, boom, with an offensive way of punching. We had big movement, big stepping, keep your arm up, defend. Which kamae I'm using? Dokono kamae. We had boom, circular movement, and we have boom, like stepping out, pressuring forward, skipping stone principle, bam, into the face of the person. Enjoy, keep your partner healthy, otherwise the group will be smaller. But for you to understand something, ninjutsu was built as a martial arts for weapon. It was never meant that you and I have a fist fight over, you know, I spill my coffee, all this bullshit, you know, what kicked you today. It was meant that, what Takamatsu sensei used to say, is if we fight, I should try to kill you. Why? If I attack you, I should have a reason. If not, I shouldn't attack you. If you attack me, you probably have such a bad reason. If I don't kill you, maybe you will be successful second time. So this was a different timing, but we don't live in this era no more. It's healthy, it's good, but for you to understand, it was built for weapons. So it can be a machete, it can be a ninja tool, it can be a knife, it can be a stick. Any weapon, it was designed for the strong hand, the stronger and faster hand forward. This is what I believe. This is the conclusion that I come to. Because let's say I have a knife, and I stand like this here, and you make a cut into my arm, then you know, I will bleed, I will be shocked. You know, this is, by the way, for you, if you ever cut somebody, show him the knife after you cut him. Because then he will see, he will realize, you look at his arm, they get shocked and they will get shaken. If you can cut a person a few times, you know, he will run into you and also kill you, and in the end you will both look at each other dying. That's not the idea. But the strong, I'm a lefty, so I stand left side, the faster the strong hand is forward. I'm not waiting for one good punch, I want to do many good punches, plus the second hand helping me, assisting me in that, you understand? I will also never, there are situations in a kata that you can show your weapon to many people, say, you really want this, you know? But if you come closer, the hand should come closer, because if you cut the hand, I will not only lose the hand, I will lose also the knife, get it? So I should be in moving, using six directions, for example. So the strong, the fast hand should be forward. If you want to give somebody a slap, not the strongest punch you have, which hand would be using your favorite hand, your strong hand? Okay, so we already learned somehow today that we don't have to use 100% strong hit, because if you want to give somebody 100% the strongest hit, it will be a bit slow also.
Like you see sometimes when people, they want to use or create body strength. In Aikido, the master would stand like this and inhale and would be so strong. You just need to look at your watch and wait for him to exhale or to pass out, because nobody can be strong all the time. Understand? It's really a life lesson. Sometimes you're weak, you should find your happiness in life. You cannot always run around in a paranoid fashion. The same is also in a fight. You cannot be 100% tense all the time, especially not before. Of course, the more tense you will be, the slower you will be. You know, what is power? Is speed, and you know the acceleration of muscle. So if you cannot accelerate, you don't have power. Very simple. So you gotta be relaxed now. So, is the question is answered? I don't know. Maybe. Let's go.
Answer for another.
Okay. You want one of you? Let's assume for a second. So now let's get to the second hand. So far, we explained you, or I explained you, we do the kata tutsuki, so I can practice the same idea of using the hand 2 or 3 times, left and right. But there's more to it. The using of hands, let's say it comes one hit, so bang, bang, immediately with the second hand while I go out for these movements. That's like he tried to tip me as fast as possible after the first block, and I tried to get away from it, okay? You see, he's weak with me, you know, but you saw he get me? So, of course, you know, I could be a bit more far away, and I could use the angle a little more exact 45. But if you really come, boom, boom, 1, 2, 3, 4 punches, it will not help me so much, you understand? So, how we solve that problem? By using the second hand. Something that Sensei did a few times in a Taikai, but nobody really noticed. My teacher, Moshe Castile, at one point, he took all the situations he saw of Hatsumi Sensei performing, let's call it Chinese boxing-like techniques, and put them into an order of 15 basic boxing techniques. And we took these 15 basic boxing techniques into 4 categories, A, B, C, D, is that you have one scenario that you will spar, because we have 5, 6 different distances our students train in. Number one is ground grappling. Number two is wrestling. Can be judo, can be tai clinch, ninjutsu, whatever. Number three will be close range boxing. Number four, boxing. Number five will be kicking. And number six will be a distance, we call it space. You know, it's like, let's say I have a knife and he will cut me. So boom, see, I can, while going out, I'm out of reach, but I could cut his arm. And for me, it's when he goes inside, boom, it's just a small movement, and he still cannot reach me, understand? The second hand is also waiting. Where did we steal this idea from? Goki no kata. One, and this hand is here, and I can still come back, or come around, or let's say we are resting, he push me, and I try to make a second, and he gave me off balance, or while I'm putting still the weight, I'm using the same stepping of Goki no kata. In a knife fight, machete, in a wrestling match, anything. So Goki no kata is also something hidden, the idea of stepping in distance. So, let's get back to the second hand. And punch, 1, 2, second hand come immediately. And this hand helps me, see? This hand delays his attack for the second block. And or I come here, or if you want to stay with Jumonji no kata for a second. Let's do it. There's a different angle for a second. And punch, 1, 2. And the moment the second hand comes, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, hitting him again. Okay? Many different movements. So let's do quick. 1, 2, okay? The hand is already here punching, put both hands up. Okay? The arms are here, and I can still use all the ideas. You get it? That's too slow together. Come on. Kion, always be one line. Don't be shy. Come on, let's use the time we have. We are standing 45. The left leg front, you have to be a lefty for a second, sorry. Use the hip up, down, left, right, forward, backward. Feel the energy you can have. Could be the same here. Arms are up, head is defended. So I have one block, one hit to the face, boom, boom. And he hits me second time. Now look what for a second what I can do. This is a diagonal way. So I make a step over and I have a diagonal fashion just on the other side. The same Jumonji I have with the arm. I create boom with the left. So what do I do? While I go back, I deflect the hand, I use the Jumonji block, and I hit again with the second hand. I don't get a solid situation. Easy. Okay. Boom, second hand.
box. Now, all of a sudden, you want to cut a start. You have to slow, bump, bump. It functions the same, doesn't it? You hit, boom, boom. This is already a hit, but could be the block. This is a preparation for my arm up with a second hit, or with a second hit. Get it? One, two, preparing. Ichimonji no kamai, jumonji, ichimonji no kamai, again, korai no kata, using kamai for fighting, boom, boom, for the same movement. Try slow to get used to it. If I have the second hand here, I put immediately this, very unlikely. It will be a short break, or it will be a bit faster, both can be. But without the hip, just throwing one hand just to touch the other person, this is stupid. Even give your friend some time. Let's try this movement into the basic kata for 1 second. He will be ichimonji. You know, I will choose a distance that he will actually can get me. He comes with the first punch. So I have 1, 2, 3. Second punch. 1, 2, 3. And from here, let's say, Tobi outside and stay with Kosei no kamai. So you use this movement just to give yourself a little more time. Let's say I was lazy. Punch, bam, bam. He hit the second time faster. I still have this hand. I don't know if he punched cross or straight. This hand is still here. That's why we use the kamai. So let's say I use this hand wrong. Doesn't matter so much. Bam, bam. There's still one hand that should be up using the block. You use the angulation. You use the kamai. You have a backup hand using again a kamai. So if you use the angulation, if you use the kamai, you understand it doesn't matter so much if you use the cross-stepping, or if you use the basic stepping, or if you stay on one side, it doesn't matter so much. Really understand that. So maybe do it a little slower, and in a Kihon style with Tutsuki, and once you manage that, you can do one the faster version, staying compact towards the other one. Enjoy. Let's come to the last part. The Tobi is not so interesting, because I guess all of us can do a Tobi wonderfully. The other way of ending the kata, after this you are sort of Kosei, okay? So you come from Kosei, back to Jumonji, back to Kosei. One way of doing it, traditionally. So, all the kamai, they blend in wonderfully. From Hoku no kamai, to Jumonji, to Ichimonji, to Doko, back to Jumonji, back to Kosei, back to Hoku. You see, it's all one. So, how do we use that? Tomei, you'd like to help me? Thank you. Let's say we are in distance number, I just made it up a few weeks ago, so I have to count whatever, ground fighting, wrestling, okay, distance number 3. In this distance, not on the kamai, I am here, I don't want any trouble with you, we're standing normally. You say, look, sorry, I always have my hands up, so please, come on, understand. Look, you're the Israelis, you know how to talk with the hands, you know the joke with the avatars, no? Hold it, I don't know why. Keep your hands up so you have a small, short distance, not of power to hit him. He keeps his hands up. I said, look, I don't want to hit him. I don't want, what is this? The moment I feel pressure, you know, I can always put the arm up or pull him. Many different things I will show you after with him for a second. I immediately come, the moment I feel pressure, I come from Kosei to Jumonji, sorry, or to Kosei to the other side. And this is very quick. The one that touches it, boom, it's immediately, I'm in. And the same can be from the inside. I'm here, I said, whoa, sorry. Okay? So I use kamai. I was in Kosei, I'm in Jumonji, I'm again in Kosei. Bang, bang, breaking, all different moves. So, it's the same as with the boxing technique. Boom, I can just punch him, or he blocks me up, boom, inside. And from here, wonderfully, all the basic techniques could come up, you see? The moment he blocks from the inside, bam, I come in, I attack you, we have Temakura, Omotek, Yaku, all different joint locks come from this boxing scenario. But we start by using the kamai. We have Kosei, he lets both hands up, say, hey, look, I don't want, control the second hand, boom, Hichu, and again. So from Kosei, Ujumonji, to Kosei, almost like Taiji. Try, you know, control your partner using this 2.5 or 2 kamai. If he decides for some reason not to put up his second hand, my changing from Kosei no kamai, of course I could still stay on this side hitting all different funny ideas, it's already a hit. Boom.
boom, boom. You see, it's the same heat, the same concept from here that we had before. Let's say there's a second hand that I have, bam, you hit me. Same concept I had before with the deflecting hand. But it's always into a certain field. You don't try to fish, because some of you are fishing. Because why you fish? I see immediately who does more sparring or who has more experience in sparring, who not so much. Because if you don't spar enough, you will start to fish. Imagine you would, in front of you, you have, you went with your, she never wants anything, my wife. It's very hard to buy something for her. But let's say she wants to buy shoes, which she never wants. You have a small, you know, cage for shoes. 38. Done. And then into this box, I hit. And if Daniel will run into me stupidly like the rest of whom, his face will be in the box. If he will hit quick, you know, touch boom, so his arm was in the box. If he just tricked me and play like a punch boom, I have the arms up, but I don't block, I don't deflect, I don't do big movements that will lead to me getting punched. I work inside the box. Doesn't matter with a sword, with a knife, or with a fist. I will not try to fall for any stupid activity. This is why, for example, the movement in the beginning, when I show you this Urastom, against the sweet slab. The beginners, they practice it in three ways. You know, I keep my arms up, he comes on the left slab, boom, Urastom is blocked. He comes on the right slab, boom, Urastom, while blocking, while hitting. Could be this hand, or he just plays like a one more, boom, and I do the same. I don't know if he just want to tease me and then come with a headbutt or kick or wait for his friends or want to intimidate me or if he want to punch left or right. I don't know what it will be. I just do my basic small step so I don't get an uppercut and I have my head covered. Which kamae is that actually? Something like Doko no kamae, like Kosei. You search the internet, you find Tatsumi, Doron, Takamatsu standing in all of these beautiful postures. So I didn't invent it. You get it. It's just how we put these things together. So when you do this exercise, try to put more pressure. It's not that of course I could be lifting, like Bagua, lifting his arm, turning his arm, and then pushing him, okay? It's good that they can because they're both 100 kilos something. You know, usually in the martial arts video, doesn't matter ninjutsu, other you have a master 100 something kilo, and a 60 kilo student, and you push him around, and everything will function then, you know? It's good that they are heavy, you see it works for people. So. Here, boom, it's a hit, bam, and then from here you put the pressure. That is the idea. Look what you want. The same what I told you before. It's not that I'm acting. Let's say he's a weak guy. I do it not on the face. We do it here for a second, okay? He doesn't resist. Already punching his face. If he resists, boom, he gives me exactly what I want. He gives me something that I want to react to. Now I can use the kamae. Bang, from here. Throw him or whatever you like. So, if you come from Kosei, the Jumonji to the Kosei is a hit. Boom, 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 using kamae. Now we can do the photo in the end. Try it. Exploding, doesn't matter. Both is good for you because this balance is on this level. The second hand will make him fly like in the movies. Yeah, but if you want Adam in jail, I don't know what they do to guys to you like, but to me, I don't want that. No chance. Okay. We have more time, I think? Not so much. Huh?
Not so much.
Let's sit for a second. Usually the best part of the lesson. Might be missing in your training or in my training, not because I don't know or he don't know. It's because for a certain time, and this can be months or years or decades, a teacher wants to put a focus on something. And I recommend you very much, once you find a good teacher, which all of you did, stay, trust in your teacher. For me,
look, usually I have an ego till the sky, you know, but you know, once you're married, you get humble. But basically for me, with my teacher, with Moshe Castile, it sounds stupid what I would tell you, you know. He can kill me, I don't care. Really, I don't care. It's not that everything he does, I approve. It is not everything he will do, I will do the same way. But he tell me something, I do. I like, no like, you know, if I am not stuck in emotions like this, you know, very free. I see it like this. I love him very much. I love what he does. Everything I have, I owe to him. So if he wants something, I do. Very simple. And I just recommend you, because I know Yossi very short time, but we connect very good, very quick. You have a wonderful teacher. It's a once in a lifetime opportunity to train with a real teacher. So I recommend you the same feeling, you know, because he will not harm you in any way. And even though for some years you will not do certain things and focus more on other things, doesn't matter. Because once the ball is rolling, you saw all the different bases, you will find a way to adapt to the situation. Because this is basically all what ninjutsu is about. The beauty in the art is its adaptability to anything that could happen. And anything that could happen also in life, not regarding a fist fight or a war or anything. So this is why we call ninjutsu actually really a lifestyle. This is how we see it. How you eat, what books you read, how you treat other people, how you respect your surrounding, yeah, all these things. You know, it all blends into one beautiful art, and it will make your life very rich if you stay with it.
I think that this is the beauty, the real beauty of our art, that we have both. We have the fighting, we have the toughness, we have the drills, the randori, the sparring, we have all these ideas, and we have the creativity and the beauty and the relaxation, because how long can you fight every day or for how many years? I don't know, I'm doing this now for 30 years. I'm now 30 years a student of Castile. So how, you think you can 30 years every day do randori and weightlifting and running and fighting and full power? No way, you will feel your body very much. And I intend to do it another 30 years at least. So I try to stay healthy. So it's always good to find a mixture between fighting and teaching and learning and doing soft work and all this. And the real beauty, what I saw in ninjutsu, is I don't know if any one of you practices other martial arts. Since it's really jutsu, it's really an art, open. Art has no fixed form. It doesn't have a beginning, like Sanshin no Kata, no beginning, no end. It's always continuous flow of options, of possibilities, of developing further. So the beauty is once you really master that, you will be able basically to grab the essence of any other martial arts. If you take a Taiji guy and make him learn karate, or a Brazilian jiu-jitsu guy to make him combat Thai boxing, it's very hard to transition. One is used to mellow and soft moves, or to just to feel the energy and then to give it back, and one is only used to it. It's very hard, but with ninjutsu, once you hit the Shodan level, you can basically, you can collect martial arts very quick. You very, very quick, you understand all the essence of the art. And I believe, the way I say it, they always like when I say this word, ninjutsu is an eclectic art. That's how I learned from my teacher. You can take all the other arts and incorporate it into ninjutsu and possibly make this art better, and by taking the essence from this art, make ninjutsu better. Very simple example. Bagua and Shingi, they are two kung fu styles that some people claim that these are the roots of Yoko and Kotoryu. And then Takamatsu sensei went to China, and just like Ueshiba, who learned Bagua kung fu, Takamatsu also learned Shingi and Bagua. And then my teacher again incorporated a lot of drills from these two arts. For many years we had to do it into it. So for the third time, these two arts at least crossed their paths. So there's some connection. So you don't need to be a master in Bagua and Shingi, you know, all these things, you know. No need. Once you practice a little, you will find immediately how to use this. My son, David, my older son, I have two older sons, David and Aaron. Aaron is 16. He's a very concentrated guy, and he will, if he will be a student here, he will listen very much, and he will try to get the best out of it. And he makes up at home, he makes up his own mind on it, and he will ask. Very different, very interesting way of learning. The older one, David, he's very straight, very, very straight with everything. You cannot bullshit with him. We had a teacher for a nice guy from the Jewish community in Hamburg for Sistema and another Chinese fighting style, I always forget the name, Ichuan, and you also know Shingi and all these things. And he showed a certain form and he explained how the nervous system functions. And my David, he loves biology, he said, no, this is not all the nervous system. So he wanted to get him off his back. He said, look, if you practice this for 8 years, then you will know to fight. He said, look, come on. 8 years is like buying a cat in a sack. If I cannot fight with it now, it's also wrong how we see it. I'm more open to it, but you understand, 8 years is too long. You really want to learn 8 years another martial art and then to find out you cannot use it? Once you know ninjutsu, you don't need 8 years and 5 years. Immediately you will find the beauty in the other art and the connectability of our art. So it will be ninjutsu alone is a never-ending journey, and now it's a never-ending journey in every direction, like ninjutsu should be. And remember, Takamatsu used 9 different old ninjutsu or ninjutsu-related traditions, plus 18 Chinese and Korean martial arts that he learned. And doesn't say that he had a black belt or all this. He just learned it. He knew how to. You really think this guy, this small guy from Japan, he learned 18 different martial arts, plus 9 these ninjutsu-related styles, so you're already 27, plus a few jujitsu and karate styles. You think really this guy, he did 35, 40 martial arts, still black belt, everything perfect? Come on. The day has only 24 hours. Let's cut all the crap and forget all the nice stories about how it was in the past. You know, my grandma used to say every good old time was once a bad new time. He never spent 20 hours a day learning every martial art. Once he understood the essence of martial art, it was easy for him to grasp the essence of the other ones.
Yuri, you're a bad